This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Richard Mosey Burr, born November 30, 1955, is the senior United States Senator from North Carolina, having served since 2005 a member of the Republican Party. Burr represented North Carolina's 5th Congressional District in the United States House of Representatives from 1995 to 2005. Prior to his political career, he worked for 17 years in private business with Carswell Distributing Contents 1 Background 2 U.S. House of Representatives 3 United States Senate 31 Elections 311-204-312-2010-313-2016-32 Tenure 33 Committee Assignments 34 Caucus Membership 4 Political Positions 41 Abortion 42 Economic Issues 43 Environmental Issues 44 Health Policy 45 Judiciary 46 National Security 47 Privacy 48 Gun Policy 49 Social Issues 410 Social Security and Medicare 5 Electoral History 6 References 7 External Links Background Burr was born in Charlottesville, Virginia, the son of Martha Nay Gillum and the Rev. David Horace White Burr, a minister. He graduated from Richard J. Reynolds High School in Winston-Salem, N.C. in 1974 and earned a B.A. in Communications from Wake Forest University in 1978. Burr was on the football team at both Reynolds High School and Wake Forest. Burr lettered for the Demon Deacons during the 1974 and 1975 seasons, however, the team went winless. In ACC play during his tenure, he is a member of the Kappa Sigma fraternity. Prior to running for Congress, Burr worked for 17 years as a sales manager for Carswell Distributing Company, a distributor of lawn equipment. Burr is currently a board member of Brenner Children's Hospital, as well as of the Group ID Alliance, a group of local, academic, and government officials working to expand North Carolina's Piedmont Triad Research Park. Burr is also a board member of the West Point Board of Visitors. Burr has been married to Brooke Foth Burr, a real estate agent, since 1984, and the couple has 2 sons, Tyler and William. Burr's father, a minister, said that Burr is a 12th cousin of Aaron Burr, the former vice president, senator, lawyer, and Continental Army officer known most for killing founding father Alexander Hamilton in an 1804 duel. He is the first Burr in the Senate since Aaron Burr served as the senator from New York, and only the second person with his last name to win election to Congress, the first being the presumably unrelated Albert G. Burr. Since Aaron Burr himself has stated that there are no longer any direct descendants of Aaron Burr, and that he descends from Aaron's brother. However, it is more likely that Senator Burr is descended from the brother of Aaron's father, as biographies of Aaron Burr state that he had only an older sister, that his parents died young and they were raised by his father's brother. When queried, Burr states that he has tempered pride of the association. I am, though history has proved to shine a different light on him. Burr's iconic 1973 VW thing, front rear, showing campaign bumper stickers of fellow Republicans. Burr's car, a 1973 Volkswagen thing, is something of a local celebrity. On Capitol Hill, U.S. House of Representatives in 1992, Burr ran against incumbent Democratic Representative Stephen L. Neal and lost. He ran again in 1994 after Neal chose not to seek re-election, and was elected to Congress during a landslide year for Republicans. He ran on a platform that advocated accountability for the federal government, lower health care costs, economic development, and strong school systems. While in the House, Burr authored the FDA Modernization Act of 1997. He helped to create the National Institute for Biomedical Imaging and Bioengineering, and after the attacks of 9/11, he successfully sponsored amendments to improve defenses against bioterrorism. As a representative, Burr co-sponsored with Senator Kit Bond R. Moe an amendment to the Energy Policy Act of 2003 relaxing restrictions on the exports of specific types of enriched uranium, first enacted in the Schumer Amendment to the Energy Policy Act of 1992. The original Schumer Amendment placed increased controls on U.S. civilian exports of weapons-grade highly enriched uranium HEU to encourage foreign users to switch to reactor-grade low-enriched uranium LEU for isotope production. HEU is attractive to terrorists because it can be used to create a simple nuclear weapon, while LEU cannot be used directly to make nuclear weapons. The amendment allowed exports to 5 countries for creating medical isotopes. Burr did not face a serious challenge in any of his re-election campaigns. United States Senate Elections 2004 Main article, United States Senate election in North Carolina, 2004. In July 2004, Burr won the Republican primary to seek the U.S. Senate seat being vacated by Democrat John Edwards, who had launched a presidential campaign. He faced Democratic Party nominee Erskine Bowles and Libertarian Tom Bailey. Burr won the election by 5 percentage points. 2010 Main article, United States Senate election in North Carolina, 2010. Burr defeated North Carolina Secretary of State Elaine Marshall Dee on November 2, 2010, with 55% of the vote. He is the first Republican since Jesse Helms to be re-elected to the United States Senate from North Carolina. He also broke the curse that his seat held, being the first senator re-elected to the seat since 1968 when Sam Ervin won his final term. 2016 Main article, United States Senate election in North Carolina, 2016. Burr defeated Democratic nominee Deborah K. Ross in the November 2016 general election by a margin of 51-45. Burr was a supporter of and campaign advisor for the presidential election bid of Donald Trump tenure in 2007. Burr ran for the leadership post of Republican conference chairman but lost to Sen. Lamar Alexander by a vote of 31-16 in 2009. He was chosen to serve as chief deputy whip in the 111th Congress in 2007. Burr was named a deputy whip in 2011. He announced his intention to seek the post of minority whip, the number two Republican position in the Senate, but he dropped out of that race in 2012. Committee assignments: Committee on Finance, Subcommittee on Health Care, Subcommittee on Energy, Natural Resources and Infrastructure, Subcommittee on Fiscal Responsibility and Economic Growth, Committee on Health, Education, Labor, and Pensions, Subcommittee on Employment and Workplace Safety, Subcommittee on Primary Health and Aging, Select Committee on Intelligence, Chairman, Caucus Membership, Congressional Boating Caucus, Co-Chair, International Conservation Caucus, Sportsman's Caucus, Weapons of Mass Destruction, Terrorism Caucus. Political positions: Abortion. Burr has voted to oppose late-term abortion and to support parental notification laws and efforts to restrict federal funding of Planned Parenthood. Economic issues: Burr voted against the Financial Reform Bill Restoring American Financial Stability Act of 2010. Dodd-Frank. In the June 26 debate, he stated, "I fear we're headed down a path that will be too overburdensome, too duplicative. It will raise the cost of credit. Government playing a bigger role with a stronger hand." In fall 2008, during that year's financial crisis, Burr described his response to problems in the U.S. financial system. "On Friday night, I called my wife and I said, 'Brooke, I am not coming home this weekend. I will call you on Monday tonight. I want you to go to the ATM machine, and I want you to draw out everything it will let you take, and I want you to go tomorrow, and I want you to go Sunday.' I was convinced on Friday night that if you put a plastic card in an ATM machine, the last thing you were going to get was cash." This statement attracted attention from the national press when an April 2009 story in the News and Observer made it more widely known. In late April, Burr told WFAE, a public radio station in North Carolina, "Absolutely, I'd do it." He said that the exact situation we were faced with was a freeze bank to bank, and as I stated, my attempt was to make sure my wife had enough cash at home to make it through the next week. Burr also said that it was not an attempt to run a bank, and nor was it a bank that was even considered then or now to be in trouble. Burr is a signatory of the Taxpayer Protection Pledge. In February 2009, he added an amendment to the proposed economic stimulus package that would end the automatic pay increases of Congress. Burr wrote on his Senate blog, "As the law is currently written, Congress has to hold a vote to disapprove an automatic pay raise, as you can guess, these votes don't happen too often." Burr opposes raising the federal minimum wage, and believes that decision should be made by the states. He is opposed to the Trans-Pacific Partnership TPP. Environmental issues: U.S. Senators Bob Corker, Richard Burr, Lamar Alexander, and Congressman John Duncan, among others, at the Great Smoky Mountains National Park in 2009. Burr was one of 21 senators who voted against the Omnibus Public Land Management Act of 2009. Supporters of this measure stated that its provision enjoyed bipartisan backing in Congress and strong local support in the areas affected, and would protect millions of acres of wild land. Opponents said that it was laden with expensive earmarks, that it precluded oil and gas production on large tracts of federal land, and that it would harm rural economies. Burr supports the Land and Water Conservation Fund, which safeguards natural areas, water resources, cultural heritage, and recreational opportunities. It uses revenues from the depletion of offshore oil and gas in 2011. Burr said he was was unsure how much human activity contributed to climate change, and that he doesn't think science can prove it. He has supported the lowering of federal taxes on alternative fuels, renewal of the Land and Water Conservation Fund, and the initiation of a hydropower project on the Yadkin River in Wilkes County, North Carolina in 2013. He voted to create a point of order against legislation that would create a federal tax or fee on carbon emissions. Burr voted in favor of the Keystone XL pipeline in a series of roll call votes attached to debate about the Keystone XL pipeline on January 21, 2015. He voted against Amendments 58 and 87, which were written to express the sense of Congress regarding climate change. A vote for the amendment was to declare that climate change is real, human-caused, creating problems, and that the U.S. must shift from fossil fuels to sustainable energy. Health policy. Burr voted against the Patient Protection and Affordable Care Act in December 2009, and he voted against the Health Care and Education Reconciliation Act of 2010 in 2014. Burr sponsored the Patient Choice, Affordability, Responsibility and Empowerment Act along with Senator Orrin Hatch. The bill is intended to provide an alternative health care reform system to the Affordable Care Act. According to Ripon Advance, the bill would repeal the Affordable Care Act and implement provisions related to consumer protections, pre-existing conditions, and consumer-directed health care measures. Burr opposes the regulation of the tobacco industry by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration FDA during the 108th Congress. Burr proposed the National Uniformity for Food Act, which would have banned states from forcing manufacturers to include labels other than those that are required by the Food and Drug Administration on consumables and health and beauty products. A similar bill passed the House, but it died in the Senate Judiciary. Senator Burr opposed a vote to confirm U.S. Supreme Court nominee Merrick Garland and blocked the nomination of Patricia Timmons Goodson to fill a vacancy on the federal court bench in eastern North Carolina, which, he proudly notes, is the longest federal court bench vacancy in U.S. history. Burr said that if Hillary Clinton is elected president, he would try to block her from ever filling the Supreme Court vacancy, saying, "I am going to do everything I can do to make sure 4 years from now, we still got an opening on the Supreme Court." National Security. Burr was the sponsor of Senate Bill 1873, the Biodefense and Pandemic Vaccine and Drug Development Act of 2005, nicknamed BioShield 2, which he says will give the Department of Health and Human Services additional authority and resources to partner with the private sector to rapidly develop drugs and vaccines. Portions of Senate Bill 1873 were eventually included in Senate Bill 3678, the Pandemic and All Hazards Preparedness Act, which was signed into law in December 2006. Some provisions of the Patriot Act, including those enabling the bulk collection of metadata for private telephone records by the National Security Agency, were scheduled to expire at the end of May 2015 as chairman of the Senate Intelligence Committee. Burr proposed extending the provisions for 2 years, but his amendments were defeated after the provisions expired. The Senate passed the USA Freedom Act, which instead allowed the NSA to subpoena the data from telephone companies. Burr supported President Bush's troop surge in Iraq in January 2007, citing the need for security and stability privacy in April 2016, following the FBI-Apple encryption dispute in the same year. A discussion draft of a bill sponsored by Burr and Senator Dianne Feinstein was leaked. The bill would require technology companies to design their encryption so that they can provide law enforcement with user data in an intelligible format when required to do so by court order. Gun policy. Burr is generally opposed to tighter restrictions on gun rights. He voted against the 2013 legislation, which would have extended background checks to internet and gun show weapons purchases. He sponsored legislation to stop the U.S. Department of Veterans Affairs from adding the names of veterans to the National Instant Criminal Background Check System, NICS, if the department has assigned a financial fiduciary to take care of their finances due to mental incompetence, unless a judge or magistrate deems them to be a danger. Persons added to the NICS system are barred from purchasing or owning a firearm in the United States. Burr voted against Senator Dianne Feinstein's no-fly, no-buy bill, but said he is open to legislation blocking gun sales to terrorists if due process is observed. Speaking privately on the topic of guns to a group of GOP volunteers in Mooresville, NC, Burr joked that a magazine cover of Hillary ought to have had a bullseye on it. He quickly apologized for the comment. Social issues. On December 18, 2010, Burr voted in favor of the Don't Ask, Don't Tell Repeal Act of 2010, the only Southern Republican senator to do so. The repeal would go on to end the core aspect of official Department of Defense employment discrimination against openly gay individuals. Burr and John Ensign were the only senators who voted against cloture. but voted in support of the final passage Senator Susan Collins R. of Maine, who spearheaded the fractional Republican Party support for the repeal, expressed grateful surprise at Burr's joining her group in the final vote. "I think that was a gutsy vote," said Collins. "He was not someone who I thought to lobby." Burr strongly expressed his opposition to the timing of the vote, reasoning he said that the chaos of double wars warranted delay, but decided it was right to support the bill when the Senate decided to stop waiting on same-sex marriage. Burr's personal belief is that marriage is between a man and a woman. However, he believes that the law should be left to the states. Burr thinks that people should use the bathroom that matches the sex on their birth certificate, but he has also sought to distance himself from HB 2, the North Carolina bathroom legislation. Burr voted for reauthorization of the Violence Against Women Act in 2013. In March 2015, Burr voted for an amendment to establish a deficit-neutral reserve fund to allow employees to earn paid sick time, Social Security, and Medicare. In 2012, Burr co-sponsored a plan to overhaul Medicaid. His bill would have raised the eligibility age from 65 to 67 over time and added more private insurance options. The proposal would have begun a transition to a system dominated by private insurance plans. Electoral history: North Carolina's 5th congressional district. Results: 1992-2002 year Democratic votes PCT. Republican votes PCT, third party party votes PCT, third party party votes PCT. 1992 Stephen L. Neal 117,835 53%, Richard Burr 102,086 46%. Gary Albrecht Libertarian 3,758 2%. 1994 AP Sandy Sands 63,194 43%, Richard Burr 84,741 57%. 1996 Neil Grist Kashin Jr. 74,320 35%, Richard Burr 130,177 62%. Barbara J. Howe Libertarian 4,193 2%, Craig Berg Natural Law 1,008 1%, 2000 No candidate, Richard Burr 172,489 93%, Stephen Francis LaBeouf Libertarian 13,366 7%, 2002 David Crawford 58,558 30%, Richard Burr 137,879 70%. Write-in and minor candidate notes: in 1992, write-ins received 4 votes. 52% Tom Bailey Libertarian 47,743 1% 2010 Elaine Marshall 1,145,074 43% Richard Burr 1,458,046 55% Mike Beidler Libertarian 55,682 2% 2016 Deborah Ross Richard Burr Sean Ha Libertarian write-in and minor candidate notes. In 2004, Walker F. Rucker received 362 votes U.S. Senate Republican primary election in North Carolina. 2004 party candidate votes percent percent Republican Richard Burr 302,319 88% Republican John Ross Hendricks 25,971 8%. Republican Albert Lee Wiley Jr. 15,585 5% U.S. Senate Republican primary election in North Carolina. 2016 party candidate votes percent percent Republican Richard Burr Inc. 627,263 61% Republican Greg Brennan 257,296 25%. Republican Paul Wright 86,933 9% Republican Larry Holmquist 50,505 percent References Carrot Senator Burr, about, U.S. Senator Richard Burr of North Carolina Senatag of 17 December 2012 Retrieved 3 November 2016. Carrot Richard M. Burr R. The Washington Post. Uranium Nuclear Control Institute Retrieved April 20, 2013. Carrot Politico, Richard Burr won't seek Republican whip. Carrot Leventova, Hannah September 16, 2016 Anti-abortion activists can't count on Trump so they're getting creative. Mother Jones retrieved 21 October 2016. Filibuster strategy, the height of hypocrisy. Washington Post retrieved August 16, 2014. Carrot oppose omnibus land grab act of 2009. Save the trails retrieved the 10th of January 2010. Carrot National Journal, the 11th of February 2011. Behind a paywall at http://nationaljournal.com/pictures-video/congressional-republicans-and-their-differing-views-on-climate-change-pictures-20111202. Carrot Duke Energy invests in keeping a climate science rejecting U.S. Senate facing South retrieved 3 November 2016. Number 12, the 21st of January 2015 http://usenetgov/legislative/lee/roll_call_lists/roll_call_vote_cfmcfmcongress=114. Carrot ABCD Raju, Manu 1 September 2015 Richard Burr quips about gun owners shooting Hillary Clinton, CNN PoliticsCom CNN.com retrieved 3 November 2016. Privacy Motherboard. USA TodayCom retrieved 3 November 2016. Carrot Morgan, Deborah March 27, 2013 Q. Carrot AB Election Statistics Office of the Clerk of the House of Representatives archived from the original on July 25, 2007 retrieved 8 August 2007. Representatives from North Carolina's 5th Congressional District 1995-2005 succeeded. 2005 present served alongside Elizabeth Dole, Kay Hagan, Tom Tillis incumbent preceded. E. United States Senators from North Carolina Class II Johnston Martin Franklin Turner Stokes Branch Brown Mangum Reed Bragg Abbott Ransom Butler Simmons Bailey. Umstead Broughton F. Graham Smith Lennon Scott Jordan Helms Dole Hagan Tillis Class III Hawkins Bloodworth Stone Franklin Stone Locke. Macon Iredell Mangum Strange W. Graham Haywood Badger Biggs Klingman Poole Merriman Vance Jarvis Pritchard Overman Morrison Reynolds Hoey.